Hello everybody. I apologize for the incident with the last video. I'm going to try to be a little more aware of that kind of stuff. I am making these for you after all. So without further ado, let's begin. So we, in the last video, the fourth gym badge was completed and acquired, which means we can now go into main quest 4. We are in Spirit Vale now, and the easiest way to get to the start point for the next quest is simply do slash spawn. Turn this way. The start of the next quest is in Waterson. If you look here, you see it says talk to Happy in Waterson. You need trainer level 20 in order to start it. Chances are you probably would have gotten to above trainer level 20 before you even got to the last gym. Get down here, go to this NPC here. He's the sailor that will take you to Waterson. Of course, if you have slash warp, you can just slash warp here. Happy is just right here, nice and easy. The key here for this password is you just look at every capitalized letter and then you just input that into slash answer. That's the answer, nice and simple. The main quest 4 is where things start to get more in depth and longer, so there will definitely be some cut into this episode. It is still 4:20 in the morning. But this quest has a very interesting puzzle, a couple puzzles actually. And having them in video form might help. We start digging into the real lore in this quest as well. Okay. Now we have to head over to Redgrove. Again, we're just going to take the boat. It's nice and simple. And the sailor for Redgrove is right here. Nice and simple. Now we have to go to the volcano base, which is over this way. this is the entrance. And we reach the first set of puzzles. This quest has four different lava puzzles. The first three are in this batch here, and the final one is later on within the volcano. The trick is you need to hit all the magma blocks and not double back on yourself. And if you do, you fall through, have to restart. And if you make it to the further lava puzzles and fall through, you restart from the beginning. Best way is just take this slowly. I would suggest taking off your running boots if you have them. And we go from there. You're aiming to get to the steps, of course. The first three puzzles aren't that bad, but the final one takes some time. The stairs are on this side now. Right there. So make sure you don't double back on yourself by mistake. I should say that sometimes the magma puzzle can be a bit laggy, so expect to fall through even if you don't think you did anything wrong. The stairs for this one are straight ahead. Make sure you don't go that way, block your steps. And that's that. Thank you. little bit of parkour. Fantastic. This is the fourth magma puzzle. It's a 11 by 12, I believe. And there are three different puzzles it can be. So when you're watching this video, it may not be this puzzle. I suggest taking the time to explore the puzzle a bit and then map it out. So you're trial and error-ing on like paper or something rather than getting frustrated falling through the magma blocks. I screwed up. Okay, if I had done that differently. Yeah, I see what. That's what happens when you step on obsidian. Oh, I also suggest crouching through the entire thing. Oh, shoot. I screwed up again. Just gonna keep this recording. If you get stuck underneath, there are stairs on this side. I don't know what I did the first time. I guess I didn't fill that in. Because I know I have to come back that way and enter. Oh. Okay, let me try to take a step back. I know. All right, I'm gonna take a shortcut here. I'll try to figure this out and I'll come back. Okay, so shortly after cutting that recording, I figured it out. So we'll see if I can replicate it. I'm pretty sure I already just screwed up. So far, I think I'm doing well. Okay, so I didn't screw it up. Just as a reminder, there are three different mazes that this could be, so you may not run into this maze exactly. Just be aware of that. When I should have gotten an energy ball on Alakazam. Kill me. Which means I can use my priority. I'm an idiot. I seriously need the Thunderbolt Gengar and the Energy Ball Alakazam. Having Cloyster against this is not the best last thing to have. Let's see if my priority can kill it. Fantastic. I can't believe I won that. I should not have won that. Again, I'm just doing this so it frees up a little bit of inventory space. course, the one time I don't use the Embor as lead, it's ice lead. You haven't discovered this yet. I am not the best at battling. I'm still in the process of learning type weaknesses and whatnot. It's going to be a slow battle. I'm mostly just waiting for the cloister to die. Not my moonstone. Of course, why not? Okay, I will be back in a moment when I get my Pokemon healed. All right, I'm back. I did more than just heal the Pokemon. I actually went to grab the two TMs. I got Thunderbolt and Energy Ball now, so I'll be able to take care of those water users a little easier now. So hopefully we can get through this. Should have used Ghost, but it doesn't matter. All right. It's been almost a day. We're gonna try to take out the leader now. Yeah, screw it. Add your. I forget your. Just water. Of course. Of course. I should be able to take it out. I should have done dark. Or not. I'm. Okay, so that's that. Okay. Honestly, we're just gonna take the easy route. The warped Watterson, I did not show this the other last time. To get back to Happy, just turn left from the warp, follow the road this way, and Happy is on this side. And we don't need to click Happy. But once you defeat the leader, that's the end of this quest. You just go through a lot more dialogue. After this quest, we move on to Gym 5, which is in Waterson, the city we are currently in. It is the electric and steel type gym. So that will be the upcoming video. Now that that's done with, I will see you next time.